extra. It's on a subject near and dear to all of our hearts.
And our stomachs.
And our stomach is close to our heart. I'm the guy on the left. With me, as always, my sidekick, LSV. The man I wish was my sidekick, David Webster Ochoa. And the plant that really makes it all worth it, Humph.
Ties everything together.
Yes, it really ties the set together, doesn't it, guys?
It's like the carpet.
So, food, you know, there have been a few comments on the tournament report stuff. There's always a section on food.
Right, I mean, like most tournament reports, people mention the good places you go to get food.
Yeah, unless they're Webster, who's always looking for the closest McDonald's. or Yard House, sorry.
Yeah, well, I mean, Webb's Pro Tour Austin report was titled Bleeding Barbecue Sauce because he mentioned how much barbecue he ate.
Yeah.
Literally every day.
I say he, like I wasn't complicit.
Or wait, no, it might have just been me.
Yeah, he did pay for all of it, which was nice. Very generous.
Wow, yes. Very generous. Very, very, very generous.
But anyway, so basically people were wondering why food always comes up, because to maybe someone who doesn't go to these tournaments, it doesn't seem like such a big deal.
Well, have
I
you...
mean, everyone has to eat.
Has this audience seen Magic Players? I mean, right off the bat, let me just get that one right off
Look,
there.
Look, man. It's like,
these guys talk about food a lot. Yeah, have you seen the coverage?
You just go out into the open and say, I have to lose a little weight. It's fine.
Look fatty.
Look, Webb. But anyway, so I think part of the reason that food is, you know, so important is that you're seeing a lot of people you don't get to normally see. Like, you know, like I don't see PV except for at tournaments because I live in Brazil. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You're going to places you haven't necessarily been or places that have food you can't normally get. And a big part of your trip is going out to eat with these people and at these places.
I think that's great. I mean, we're talking about Connolly's article. It's going up. Well, I guess by the time it'll already have been up.
He talks about passion being very important, and part of the, you know, thing that keeps your passion going for Magic is the fun experiences that happen at tournaments, which involve seeing these friends, and that's usually centered around meals.
You know, I think that's really important, too. Like measuring success, you know, based on how much money you make or how successful you are on the, you know, on the pro tour or making the gravy train. I mean, that's great, and that's definitely part of the calculus, but there is a larger community which you get to be part of, and I think that's a lot of the mystique of being a pro,
Well, like Conley said, like, if the only pleasure you derive from a Magic tournament is how well you finish, you're going to be disappointed at a lot of tournaments.
Yeah, you're not going to win.
Like, even when you're one of the best players in the game, you still don't do well at every tournament.
And you forgot what playing on day two feels like.
Right. No, I mean, like, I haven't made day two of the last couple of tournaments, but, you know.
You've had a great time with them, you know.
Yeah, like.
Maybe a little too much of a good time.
Yeah.
You're drafting nonstop. And then going,
well, I mean, when you go to one of these tournaments, you're either, like, at least for me, I'm either sleeping, going out to eat, drafting, or playing in the tournament.
Right, right.
And not necessarily in that order. So sleeping's usually last.
Yeah. It is one of the great luxuries if you're able to do the Pro Tour circuit. I mean, think about it. You know, Kyoto, Austin.
All I can think about when you mention these places is how often we credit card game the meals and how little I had to pay. I don't think I paid for a single meal in Hawaii or Kyoto.
Yeah.
Honolulu. Well, it was mostly Josh in Kyoto.
Yeah.
That's unfortunate.
Me and Raptor went head-to-head, like, four meals in a row, and he lost all of them.
Oh,
but
God.
It was fine in Kyoto because we always went to the Jack
Yeah, well,
Box
that was one of the awesome things about Kyoto was there was all these really cheap curry houses, mm-hmm. and you got, you know, you get good, at least to us, it was good food. Yeah. Like, I guess if you live in Japan, you might have been as sick as, you know, sick of it as we are of, like, McDonald's or whatever.
No. I mean, I think that's kind of a misnomer. Like, Japanese food isn't all just sushi. You know, go out and get
it. We weren't eating sushi.
Curry's great. Curry's hearty, great, filling. You know.
These cowards wouldn't eat. They give you the raw egg to crack into your rice.
The only
way it was awesome. But
so good.
No one else but me would eat it.
So good.
No, sir.
Man up.
But
I mean, that's part of the. See, I mean, Honolulu, even though it's part of, you know, the United States, the cuisine out there, it's crazy. You have Hawaiian barbecue. You have amazing fish. Obviously, it's an island.
Yeah, it looks like Filipino, Chinese, Japanese.
Yeah, the influence is there. You know, Spam.
And as, you know, people who follow me on Facebook or, you know, friends of me on Facebook know, I'm a big fan of pho. And in Hawaii, I had saimin, which is kind of like...
Oh, saimin's great. I don't know, it's really good.
It's the equivalent where it's you got noodles, broth, and as many toppings as you want.
Right, right.
So.
And I mean, Zippy's chili, which is something we don't have here on the mainland. It's awesome. Of course, Austin, we already covered, barbecue.
Yeah, all barbecue all the time.
No, but here's the real question. KC was barbecue, a lot of barbecue going on there, too.
I have to give the nod to Austin, I think.
Yeah. Really?
I think Arthur Bryant's was a little bit better.
Arthur Bryant's was pretty classic, like, no-frills barbecue.
So you're saying, let me get this straight. So maybe KC has the best barbecue place you've been to, but there was more good barbecue in Austin.
Yeah, I think Austin, well, we really only went to two places in Austin, so... Yeah. And that brings us to another point, which would be Webb and his various championships in terms of eating.
Webster, as you can tell from his size, his girth, if you will, is actually an eating champion.
Multiple times we've gone to Plataforma or a churrasqueria or, you know, Brazilian steakhouse. They keep bringing meat up.
Yeah. All you can eat.
And Webb has won every challenge there, you know. I even made a small wager last time we were at one of these places with another guy who works for Channel Fireball.
Who was told by many, many people at the table who generally don't have any interest of his at heart, like, hey, maybe this isn't a good idea.
I had to give him 2-for-1 odds, but it was him versus Webb head-to-head, and I also posted the results on Facebook because they gave us a sheet to...
tallying everything down.
With every meat listed, and we tallied it out, and Webb won 40 to 29. This is portions of meat eaten.
Now, keep in mind, too, just to make this even more impressive, the meat was not the best thing at this restaurant. They had these pineapples that were unbelievable.
Well, the grilled pineapple with sugar and cinnamon.
Yeah, oh, okay, that was unbelievable. The meat was, like, you know, mediocre.
Yeah. Mediocre, yeah.
I beat you to it.
It was still good meat, but compared to the other Brazilian steakhouses that we've been to, it was on the bottom.
And then we have Rome coming up. I mean, you know, that's going to be amazing. There's so much great food there. Great wine. I mean, I think I'm a bigger wine drinker than else here.
And then pizza. And then more pizza.
I like pearls before swine. We'll get you some pastel chocolates, all right?
Well.
And then some sides of breadsticks with marinara sauce.
What am I thinking? We got Minnesota before that, right, guys? You can go to Minnesota and...
Hey, I have good memories. My grandmother's from Minnesota, so, and my, you know, my mom. So I've been there a number of times, and, you know, not recently, but when I was a kid, I certainly...
Boil meat and potatoes?
I just associate it with home cooking. So.
But, I mean, I don't think there's anything... Are you really looking forward to the food in Minnesota? Like, Thank God there's GP.
Baker Square.
Here I come. I mean, I imagine, like, Minneapolis, and I hope no one takes offense. I imagine it to be, like, just chain places, you know.
I don't know. Like I said, I haven't been there at a time when I would go out and choose where I would eat myself.
I mean, we're really lucky here being in the Bay Area. Like, California in general, like, having spent a lot of time between San Francisco and Los Angeles, like, San Francisco has amazing fine dining. I used to work in restaurants. The fine dining here is second to none. In this country,
the taco trucks, like.
except for New York probably has the best. We have the French Laundry out here, but then down south, there's just amazing ethnic food. In Southern California,
there is up here too.
But when you
compare the variety of anywhere in California though to, like, a lot of places I've been, like, California definitely comes out.
I mean, the thing about LA too is, like, there's a little Ethiopia, there's a Thai town, there's a little Manila, there's Chinatown, Japantown. I mean, there's so much stuff there.
She had actually lived in Koreatown, which is unsurprisingly.
Yeah.
I remember going hanging out with them.
And K-Town has amazing food, too. And the Korean food there is unbelievable. So it's worth mentioning just because I think that people reading these tournament reports, they think, like, look, we're just reading about the game.
Definitely there for just the magic. And you can certainly read the report and just skip over to the sections that don't involve that. But I think a good tournament report delivers the essence of the tournament.
It's the whole experience.
And definitely there's
a lot more going on besides the actual rounds.
Yeah.
I mean, if you think about it, like, you know, the 15 rounds you played at Austin or the 8 rounds I played, or 16 rounds, I'm sorry, and the 8 rounds I played, like, that was the minority of the time we spent in the trip. Like, we spent a lot more time doing other stuff.
Wait, you played 16 rounds with? In Austin?
15.
Is it 16?
Yeah, it was 16.
That's not important. How many rounds did you play again, Luis?
I played as many as I was allowed to. the full month. Wait, how many rounds did you play?
I was busy doing other things. I knew you were going to attack me about my pro tour play.
Yeah.
I think that part of the experience is probably the best part.
Yeah. And I think if you don't make an effort to do stuff like this, you're missing out. Like, some of the pro tours I've enjoyed the least are the ones where I had to, like, show up the day of the pro tour, leave the day after, and, like, had no time to do anything.
Well, and the community aspect of it is where you do get help, is where, you know, people, like PV.
It's all networking, and it definitely helps network.
And so. it helps give you an edge.
Hope this shed a little light on why we always talk about the places we go eat.
The hidden life of the pro, if you will.
Yeah, I wouldn't even go that far. thanks for watching this little extra tidbit, if you will.
Yeah. Mm.
We went up to the Yard House. That was just...
You went to the Yard House in Honolulu?
Webb loved it, too.
That was the only time I've been there.
Look at all these beers.
Dude, it was pretty sweet.
Dude, no, it's not, bro. You're in Honolulu. Come on, brah.
Nah.
Oomph. Oomph. guys, ready to eat? I'm hungry.
So, dinner? what did we just
say? I mean, talk about fine dining. Webb ate literally a half a bag of Halloween candy.
Like, it was just on the table.
Someone made the mistake of leaving a bag. Hey, Webb, you know, you need someone to play with. I'll play with you.
What?
That sounded very weird.
Hey, I'll give it to Vargas.